Welcome to the Bureau's long-range forecast for spring 2023. After what looks to be our warmest winter on record, spring is also likely to bring warmer days and reduced rainfall. Let's look at recent conditions. Winter has been much drier than usual for many areas, including in the southwest and parts of the east. Large areas of northern and central Australia had above average rainfall over the winter months, mostly due to unseasonal rain in late June and early July. For Australia as a whole, rainfall this winter is tracking at around 8% below average. Winter has been warmer than average almost everywhere, except the southwest corner of WA. Overall, Australia is on track to have its warmest winter on record, with the national mean temperature around 1.5 degrees above average. Soil moisture is now very much above average across large areas of the north and some central regions, but soils are drying out in large parts of the east and some southern areas where there's been lower rainfall. Combined, Australia's water storages are close to 80% full. Many are more than 90% full. However, some storages are dropping below 50%. The long-range forecast for spring shows a high chance of below-average rainfall for most of Australia. This is very different to last year's wetter forecast for spring. Last year, spring was the second wettest on record. 2023 is looking different. Many areas have an increased chance of an unusually dry spring, with the highest chances in the southwest and parts of the east. The first rains of northern Australia's wet season are likely to be later than normal, especially for the Northern Territory and Queensland. Over the coming months, with the drier forecast and soils drying out, near median stream flow is likely for the majority of sites. Low to normal flow is forecast for most other areas. Most of the country has a high chance of daytime temperatures that are warmer than usual this spring. There's an increased chance of unusually warm days for almost all areas, especially in WA and parts of the southeast. Large areas are also very likely to have warmer than usual overnight temperatures. So what's likely to influence our climate over the coming months? We remain at El Niño alert, as it is likely an El Niño will develop this year. Sea surface temperatures are forecast to keep warming above El Niño levels. Sea surface temperatures indicate a positive Indian Ocean dipole is likely to form during spring, which can result in below average rainfall for southern and central Australia. July was the warmest month on record globally when including land and ocean temperatures. We know that a warmer climate increases the risk of extreme weather like heat waves. The outlook from the Australian Fire Agencies shows an increased fire risk for large areas of New South Wales, Queensland and the NT, plus parts of Victoria and South Australia. There's always a risk of dangerous and destructive fires in Australia during spring. With warm weather, grasses can quickly dry out and increase the risk of fast-moving fires, including near urban areas. Now is the time to prepare and review your bushfire plan wherever you are. In summary, the forecast for spring shows below average rainfall, warmer than usual temperatures, and an increased fire risk for large areas. You can find the latest long-range forecasts on the Bureau's website. Bye for now.